So cats, aren't they cute? But as anyone who's had a cat knows, at some point or another, you're gonna be on the receiving end of that cat's claws.
Ow!
Usually it's no problem. The scratch disappears in a few days. But now, the Center for Disease Control are warning cat owners to be on guard against a rising new potentially deadly infection called Catscratch Disease. And no, we didn't make this one up. Catscratch disease, or catscratch fever, is a bacterial infection that can be extremely serious. It's caused by the bacteria Bartonellahenselae, a rod-shaped bacteria found on 50% of cats. Cats transmit the bacteria through their saliva, so if they bite you or they scratch you after licking their claws, you're in trouble. Cats usually carry the disease without any symptoms of infection, the same way that you might carry bacteria on your skin without any signs of illness. We think catscratch disease is pretty rare. Most of you wouldn't freak out if you got a little scratch from your furry friend, but analysts at the CDC discovered that catscratch disease is actually a lot more common than we think. They examined national health insurance claims from 2005 to 2013 for patients aged 65 and younger, and found that every year about 12,000 people are diagnosed with catscratch disease. They also discovered that the illness requires about 500 hospitalizations annually. So while you're still more likely to die in a car accident than die in hospital with catscratch fever, it does happen, and you don't want to become any part of these statistics. If you are scratched by a cat, clean out the wound with antibacterial soap and water, and watch out for a fever with tender lymph nodes or pustules at the injury site. That's never good. Tomcats or male cats might have a slightly greater incidence of passing catscratch disease onto their human owners, possibly due to being more prone to injury through rough play with cats, and an increased risk of exposure. Children are also way more at risk of catscratch disease as they're more likely to play with cats. Those who've already had a repressed immune system from other illnesses like cancer or HIV or even the flu are much more at risk of contracting catscratch disease. So if you're currently sick, be careful. Where possible, keep your cat indoors to prevent infection from other cats, avoid rough play with your kitty, and take care of any scratches that you might have. So what do you guys think? Have we scared you by talking about cat scratch fever, or are you just gonna continue playing with your cat as normal? Do you often get roughed up by your cat and then need to be a bit more careful from now on? Or do you think that worrying about CSD is being paranoid? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.